The most cost-effective way to create an FPGA design is to combine software and hardware and to import as much of your functionality as possible by using existing IP cores. By splitting the control path into software and implementing the data path in hardware, you get the best of both worlds. You can have a software application running on the embedded processor on your FPGA that handles things like user interaction, kicking off of events in your design, or synchronizing input and output data. Stuff that doesn't require high data throughput or strict timing. And it doesn't make sense to implement that basic functionality using VHDL. It is much easier and quicker to program it in C or C++, and then you can easily change it. It takes less time to compile than to resynthesize the VHDL module. And then you can focus your energy where it matters. You can create VHDL modules where you have some special requirement for data processing. You can create your own data processing VHDL designs. But for the most part, the common tasks are handled by existing IP cores. So for most common tasks, you can import IP cores and use them instead. You don't have to develop anything. And that's how you can maximize your time. And in this course, we're going to create a system on chip design consisting of a Xilinx MicroBlaze processor. We're going to combine it with existing IP cores from the Vivado IP catalog, and we're going to create our own VHDL module to talk to the MicroBlaze. So this is the board I'm using in the course, the Arty S7 board. If you are using a different Xilinx board, that is okay. And if you don't have any board at all and just want to do it on the computer, that is also okay. Just download the free Vivado and Vitis software, and I'm going to show everything on my board anyway. So in this course, I'm going to show you how to create the block diagram, how to set up the MicroBlaze, and we're going to start very simple by flicking switches and see the output on the screen transmitted over UART. And I'm going to show you how we can connect the external DDR3 memory on this board to the MicroBlaze and how to edit the linker script and make all of that memory available for the program running on the MicroBlaze. And then we're going to step things up. We're going to use interrupts so that when we flick a switch, it's going to cause an interrupt in the MicroBlaze processor so that we can run an interrupt routine anytime something happens on the switches here. And finally, we're going to create our own VHDL module, a PWM module, a pulse width modulation module that can control the intensity of one LED. So it's controlling the brightness of an LED. And then we're going to incorporate that into our MicroBlaze design so that the MicroBlaze can control this module and set the brightness through sending data to the VHDL module. So that in the end, when we flick a switch, the MicroBlaze is going to be alerted through an interrupt and is going to send the command to our VHDL module over the AXI4 light bus and tell the VHDL module which illumination brightness is going to set on the LED. And this is an example of a system-on-chip design. I'm going to explain how everything fits together in this course, and it enables you to create complex designs in the fastest possible way by combining software, existing hardware, and hardware that you develop yourself using VHDL.